Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are sleeping with somebody that is not your husband, not your wife, then know that you are sleeping with somebody you don't know. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The day you will know that person will not be a day of celebration. It will be a day of weeping. The scripture started with two women who were sleeping together. Two women who lived together. Two women who were friends. Two women who thought they could trust one another. They were sleeping together. But one, when they got pregnant, one gave birth and the other one followed 3 days after. She did not want to wait. Because if she waited, there would be a big difference between their children. And when she would do what she was planning to do, because that is her plan, hallelujah.
Amen.
It will be easy to distinguish. So she gave birth quickly, 3 days apart. It's very difficult. I've given birth before, many times, at least 4 times. And I can assure you, Mrs. Anthony, you've given birth only 2 times, me 4 times. I'm more than you. I tell you, 3 days old babies cannot be distinguished except they have different cultures or complexions or races. But these were from the same tribe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I want to assure you that there are some children that the devil is hunting for more than others. And we know that the devil does not look for empty people. The devil is looking for destiny children. He's looking for children that shall cause a change in their family. The devil is looking for that child that will cause a transformation in the entire family, in the entire home, the entire village. Those are the type of children the devil is looking for. And when you see somebody kills a child and is looking for another one to kill, you have to understand that that child that was killed was just a pretext to take the other child and destroy him. You are dealing with people you don't know. Praise the Lord. So these people reported, these two women presented themselves to the king. And we see that it is the first time they are appearing before the king. Because the king had not seen them when they were coming to greet them. Oh, king, live forever. Oh, long live, dear king. Never. They have never appeared before the king to greet the king, to honor the king, to give him his honor, his glory. Never. The first time they are appearing before the king is a day that they have problems. Is there somebody here who has a father that they only appear before that father when they have a problem? They are wrong. Is there anybody here who has a pastor? You only appear before the pastor when you have a problem. That is wrong. Is there anybody here that has an authority over them that you only visit that authority when you have a problem? That is wrong. Let me tell you something. If those women had visited the king one day and informed the king that they were living together, the king would have said this, King Solomon, as wise as he was, he would have told them that it is not right for you two pregnant to be living together without a helper. Praise the Lord. He would have advised them that you need somebody because you are weak. You are pregnant, you are weak. You need somebody who can help you in time of need. But they never went to visit the authority. They never went to visit their pastor. They never went to visit their head. It was only when the problem was at their throat that they now went to visit the king. A lot of wisdom in this scripture. And when they got there, they were disputing the baby. The dead one was no one's child. The one that belonged to somebody was the living child. And I want to tell you, when you were in the village and you were nobody's child. But now that you are in America and you are affluent, you are driving cars, everybody is your father in Africa, everybody is your mother, everybody is your uncle. Yeah. So I'm calling and telling you, do you know I'm your uncle?
Yeah.
Somebody here?
Yeah.
If you have an uncle, will the uncle be the one to tell you?
No.
You will be seeing the uncle coming and visiting at home. Your father will be talking to you about that uncle. Your mother will be talking to you about that uncle. But this one that called you and said, remember, when they gave birth to your mother, I'm the one who carried her because she was very troublesome. She gave me a lot of trouble, but since she was my sister, I just called. So you are actually my child. They are informing you when you ought to know. Praise God. Sometimes you even hear some when they die. Remember that your uncle, the elder brother of the younger brother of the elder uncle of your younger mother of your elder mother of the, he died. Yeah. They are disputing the living child, but for the dead child, nobody cares about. Nobody cares about that one because that one has no resources anymore. That one has no destiny anymore. That one has no future anymore. That one has no tomorrow. Everybody is looking for your tomorrow. Somebody here. Listen to me. Everybody is looking for your tomorrow. If you don't have a tomorrow, nobody cares about you. But when you have a tomorrow, that's it. They come after you. They are fighting over this child. And the woman whose child died is saying that this one is mine. You killed yours. Yours is now lifeless. You are going after the one that has life, the one that has a destiny, the one that has a future. That's the one you are going after. And the Bible says, this woman began to explain to the king that when we were sleeping at midnight, this woman lay on her own child. She died. And then she carefully took mine and did the exchange. Two things there and we close. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
One, she was sleeping. How did she know that it was at midnight? Because she is the one saying that at midnight, this woman killed her own child and took mine. And then gave me his dead child. How did she know that it happened at midnight? She would have stopped it, right? If you knew it would allow it to happen, would you? She would have stopped it. How did she know? This moves me to the key of this scripture and we close. The midnight hour is a dangerous hour. The midnight hour is the hour that destinies are exchanged. The midnight hour is the hour that you lost your job. The midnight hour is the hour that you lost your visa. The midnight hour is the hour that your destiny was exchanged. Demons come out at midnight and do exchange of destinies. There is somebody who is moving in the street like a crazy man and you think that he's just being stupid. The destiny was exchanged at midnight. Those who sleep at midnight, your destinies are at stake. Those who do not know what happens at midnight, I want to allow you to know right now that midnight is the night of exchange of destinies. So this woman knew. You see some women, they cannot get married. You begin to wonder, what is wrong? They had husbands, but at midnight they were exchanged. You see some, no children. What is happening? This one has no child. Oh, at midnight. It happened. There was a switch. While men slept, the enemy came and sold theirs. That's what happened at midnight. So this woman knew that this evil could not have happened before midnight or after midnight. I want you to know that at midnight, exactly midnight, demons open their gates. And they come out and begin to ravish people. They begin to destroy destinies. They begin to exchange futures. They begin to exchange husbands. They begin to exchange wives. You will hear a woman will say, I was about to get married to this man, but he got married to my friend. What happened? It's not just the wickedness of your friend. It is the devil. He did the exchange at midnight. Brothers and sisters, it is good for us to know this. I wanted to get married to this girl. Finally, she got married to my friend. What happened? It's not her wickedness. There was an exchange that happened at midnight. Mm. When I go to work, I work and my bosses, they grade me very highly. They love me, they respect me. But when time comes for promotion, other people are promoted. I am stagnating throughout. What happens? There is an exchange. Your file is exchanged in the night. The file of the enemy is taken and your file is put on the place of the enemy. That's what happens. It is for that reason that we say prayer is powerful. No doubt. Luke chapter 18, verse number 1 says, and men ought always to pray and not faint. Why? Because there is that enemy that moves around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Let me tell you, he does not only devour people. If he cannot devour you, he devours your destiny. Yeah. He cannot devour you, devour your career. Yeah. He cannot devour you, devour your children. Yeah. He cannot. You see, there are children in drugs all over this place. Maybe you've not talked to children. Maybe you've not dealt with a school environment. I have been in school in this place. You see people all in drugs. Very youthful children that would have been useful to their families, to their parents and their communities. They are all in drugs. What happened? The enemy came. The enemy came and said, do you want this woman to really be happy? No, this woman is not going to be happy. So I will take the child of this other one and place here and take her on and place there. Yes. So the child of this woman will be languishing while the child of the enemy is flourishing at the detriment of the child of this woman. That is what happens at midnight. Brothers and sisters, demons are real. Evil is real. The spirit world is real. Praise the name of Yahweh.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus Christ is good. But he says, I came that you may have life and have it more abundantly. So that those who are in Christ, they are covered.
Amen.
You will turn left, you will see 1,000 arrows following you, but none will touch you.
Amen.
Because of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You turn right, you will not see 1,000. Because the right hand is the hand of power.
Yes.
The right hand of God is power.
Yes.
For that reason, at the left hand, 1,000 arrows shall fall. But at the right hand, 10,000. 10 times the one that fall by your left. Because the right hand is not a common hand. But none shall touch you.
Yes.
Because you are covered by the blood.
Amen.
Rabaka, shut up. Jesus is our God.
Amen.
And this is what happens. King Solomon, ask. This is what makes me to know that King Solomon represented the priests. He represented Pastor Luther. Because King Solomon asked for the sword. If you don't know the sword here, then you are joking. What is the sword? The word. King Solomon asked for the word. And the word was brought. He said, divide the child into two. Let me tell you something. If you are dealing with people, do you know what happened? When King Solomon said, divide the child into two, the truth came out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
The truth came out.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Pastor, I'm living. All right. So what happens is, when the sword came, when the word of God came, the truth came out. And this is the trick. If you want to know the people you are dealing with, bring the word of God.
Yeah.
You will see the true face of them.
Yeah.
You see their true faces. You see who truly they are. If you are dealing with people, I don't know, if you are a man, like wanting to get married to a woman, bring God into the subject. Bring God on the table. Bring Jesus Christ on the table. You will know who they are.
Yeah.
You want to enter into a business alliance with somebody, bring Jesus, bring the sword, bring the sword, bring the sword. The truth will come out. Either they will tell you, oh, no. Ah, no, I don't want that. No. That's too much religion. Too much, no. Let's keep religion out of this thing. You know who they are.
Yeah.
So the word of God was brought into question. It was brought to the table. And the truth came out.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the word of God is fire.
Mm-hmm.
The word of God is fire.
Yeah.
If this house, if we are sleeping, no matter what degree of anesthesia that you give, everybody here is sleeping. A fire is burning over this building.
That Anastasia will say, no, I will hold for a while.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People will go out.
Yes.
When they receive, the truth comes out.
Yes.
If they thought they knew each other, but the testing time came.
I want us to pray right now. Can you stand on your feet? Let's bless our prayers unto the Lord. Because the Bible says, Matthew 21:22, if you ask of God anything, whatever, and believe, He gives it to you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Say, my Lord and my God.
Unveil my friend to me.
Unveil my neighbor to me.
Unveil
my colleagues to me.
Unveil
the people close to me.
Unveil
them to me. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want to know who to trust.
I want to know
who to believe in. In the wonderful name of Jesus. I want you to pray that prayer. Say, mighty Father, in the name of Jesus, and by the power of the Holy Ghost, I begin to pray. Unveil my friends to me. Unveil my neighbors to me. Unveil my colleagues to me. In the wonderful name of Jesus. Let me know them. Let me know them. Expose them to me, my Father. Expose them to me, my God. Expose them to me, my Yahweh. In the name of Jesus Christ.